At number 29, a receiver headed to TCU from Brownsboro, GeKyle Baker. We're talking about a guy last year was number 100 on the list because Brownsboro was 2-8. And no matter how good you are as a player at the high school level, you got to be able to elevate your team. Brownsboro didn't quite, they weren't 2-8. I think they won they actually started the season out pretty on fire. I think they were 5-0 at one point. So they did really good. Adam Thompson, the quarterback, really revived the offense. And, you know, when you got a guy like Ja'Kyle Baker, you can just throw it to the top floor and ain't nobody else going to catch it. He is explosive, hard to catch after the tackle. Competes for the ball, really good at spectacular catches. Hands are superb. Would not be surprised if he goes and is an immediate impact player, sort of like a Devin McEwen from UTSA. You know, he was a three-time member of this list. This is Ja'Kyle's second time making the list. But I can see him being one of those guys that's just like sneakily gets on the field and keeps producing. TCU's probably got a little more talent than UTSA, but nonetheless, he's my sleeper to actually get on the field at the receiver position next year at number 29, Ja'Kyle Baker.
Thank you.